Hello, I'm Tom. Welcome to the Crawler-Lib-Engine simple task sample. In this sample, I show the general task building block and the design of task requests and task results. I show how the task workflow will be designed. To keep it simple, we fetch a web page and extract all links on it. And finally, I show how task requests will be created and how the results will be processed. So let's start. I've already downloaded the Crawler-Lib-Engine sample solution and opened it in Visual Studio. Now I open the simple task project and the simple task.cs code file, which contains a complete sample. First of all, I want to show how tasks are implemented. The implementation separates the concerns of requesting a task, executing a task, and returning task results into three classes: task request class, task result class, and the task class itself. The effort to implement three classes for a task is offset by the many advantages of this design. The request and result are lightweight, so that thousands of them can be created without to worry about memory footprint. The task itself is created directly before the work starts and is disposed as soon as the work is finished, so the resources are allocated as late as possible and freed as soon as possible. This is especially important when the result is compiled from many requests and a large amount of memory is needed. The task request contains all parameters for the task and must be derived from task request base and implement the create task method. In this sample, it contains the URL of the web page we want to crawl. The task result stores the crawling results and must be derived from task result base. In this sample, we store the links of the crawled page in it. Task request and task result classes should always be marked with a data contract attribute so that requests and results can be serialized. The task class itself is derived from task base and must implement the start work method. In this method, the workflow of the task is started. For convenience, the task request and task result properties of the base class are hidden and are newly defined with the correct type. This allows accessing them without a cast. Now let's take a look at the workflow of the task itself. It begins always in the start work method. You must assign task result on top of the start work method, because without a task result, no exception can be returned in case of an error. Because the Crawler-Lib-Engine is a general purpose workflow processor for data mining and information retrieval tasks, there is not only one type of a request. In this sample, we will perform a single HTTP request. The used HTTP request class is a so-called workflow element. The HTTP request is created with new and assigned to nothing. It integrates itself properly in the workflow of the task. The HTTP request has a configuration parameter where the URL and the quota properties are set, but also the action in case of successful request is set in the configuration parameter. The successful property is an action delegate. In this sample, a lambda expression with a method body is assigned to it. Any method with a correct signature will do too. The extraction of the links in the page is simple, because a request provides the HTML property, which is in fact an HTML document of the HtmlAgilityPack library. So the href nodes are simply selected from the document and the href texts are added to the links property in the result. One thing about workflow elements and synchronization. The HTTP request in this sample is not started until the start work method completes. That implies that the successful handler of the request cannot interfere with code in the start work method. This behavior removes any synchronization needs along action handlers. Before we start a sample, Let's take a look at the engine and how tasks are created and results are processed. The engine is created with a configuration object. Several memory and performance settings can be made there. An application or service should create only one engine object and send all requests to it. Here will the request be added, and here will the results be processed. Before we start a sample, let's take a look on the URL of our page in a web browser. As we see, there are 6 outbound links. Now I start a sample and a console window appears. After the license information of the anonymous edition is dumped out, the engine starts. The task is started and the results are gathered and processed. Thank you for watching the simple task sample. You can download the sample and the Crawler-Lib engine on our homepage under www.crawler-lib.net.